Hello children, right, welcome to the today's mathematics class. Today's session we are going to continue, that is the congruency of triangles. Today we are going to discuss that criteria for congruency of triangles, right? So in that, first criterion is a yes congruence criterion. That is nothing but side congruence criterion. So what is that mean here? So if under a given correspondence the three sides of one triangle are equal to the three corresponding sides. See this here, these three corresponding sides, the word is very important, corresponding. So the three corresponding sides of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. See this here children, very important. If under a given correspondence the three sides of one triangle are equal to the three corresponding sides of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. Here triangle ABC and PQR, two triangles are given. In that the side of AB is 4 cm, BC is 5 cm and AC is 6 cm. The same way in triangle PQR, PQ is 4 cm, QR is 5 cm and PR is also 6 cm. Now if you observe AB here, AB is correspondence to PQ, and as well as second one is BC is correspondence to QR, and the third one is AC is correspondence to PR. AC is correspondence to PR, then we can write it as a triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Right children, only we can discuss about your sides only. If corresponding sides are equal of the three sides of a triangle, then we can say that these two triangles are congruent to each other. This is congruent symbol, already we discussed. Right children, you please copy this. Right children, let us discuss second congruency criteria, that is a SAS congruence criterion. So now let us see here, if under a given correspondence two sides and the angle included between them, okay, what is that here? If under a given correspondence two sides and the angle included between them of a triangle are equal to two corresponding sides and the angle between them of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. That means here, suppose let us take two triangles, okay, triangle ABC, and taking AB and as well as AC in between angle A, okay. And the second triangle is a triangle XYZ, in XYZ and taking XY, XZ and angle X here. See this here, AB is correspondence to XY and the second one is AC is correspondence to XZ and the included angle. See, angle A is included between AB and as well as AC. Angle X is included between XY and XZ. So here angle A is correspondence to angle X, right? Then we can say that triangle ABC is congruence to triangle XYZ. Right children, see this here, very important. The angle is included between the two sides. And as well as here also, included between the two sides. And as well as the corresponding sides must be equal. Corresponding sides must be equal. And the angle between them are equal. Then we can say that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle XYZ. This is called SAS. side angle side. Right, children? So if under a given correspondence, two sides and the angle included between them, of a triangle are equal to two corresponding sides and the angle between them of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. This is called SAS, congruency of criterion. Right, children? Please note down this, draw the diagrams also. Right, children, let us discuss third criterion, that is ASA, congruence criterion. What is that here? If under a correspondence, two angles and the included side of a triangle, are equal to two corresponding angles and the included side of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. That means here, see, let us draw the diagrams. That is a triangle here, I'm going to take ABC, okay, and another triangle I'm going to take DEF. In DEF, see, here I'm taking that angle B and as well as angle C are two angles, and included between these two angles is BC, is the side. And here I am consider angle E, angle F are corresponding angles, and between them EF is the side here. So here in this triangle ABC, angle B is correspondence to angle E, and as well as angle C is correspondence to angle F. Clear? And as well as the side included between them, the side BC is included angle B and angle C here, and the side EF is included between angle E and angle F. So these two are correspondence. BC is correspondence to EF. Then we can write it as triangle ABC is congruence to triangle DEF. Right, children? This is called angle side angle congruence criterion. Angle side angle. Right, children, what is that here? If under a correspondence, two angles and the included side, this is the reverse process of SAS. There, we can take two sides and included angle. Here, we are taking two angles and included side between. Right, children? So, angles and the included side of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. So, these two triangles are here congruent. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. Right, children? So this is the third criterion. We have one more. You please copy this. We'll discuss one more. Right, children? The fourth one is criterion of right angle triangles. Right? So RHS congruence criterion. Right angle, hypotenuse and side. If under a correspondence, the hypotenuse and one side of a right angle triangle are respectively equal to the hypotenuse and one side of another right angle triangle, then the triangles are congruent. In right angle triangle, one angle must be 90 degrees. Clear? In a right angle triangle, we know that the slant height, the side opposite to the 90 degrees is always hypotenuse. So this is a 90 degrees. Clear, children? In triangle ABC, angle B is 90 degrees and the AC is the hypotenuse. Okay? Always in any right angle triangle, the side which is opposite to the 90 degrees is always hypotenuse. You can take any one side. I am taking BC is one side. Now, in another triangle XYZ, okay, this is 90 degrees x y z. In this xz is a hypotenuse, right? Xz is hypotenuse and yz I am taking that another side. See this here, right angle hypotenuse and side, right angle hypotenuse side, right angle hypotenuse side. If under a correspondence the hypotenuse and one side of a right angled triangle are respectively means correspondence, okay, respectively equal to the hypotenuse and one side of another right angled triangle, then the triangles are congruent. So here we are taking that right angle B is correspondence to angle Y, which is equal to 90 degrees. Angle B, angle Y, both are is equal to 90 degrees. Right angle means 90 degrees. And next, hypotenuse. Which is hypotenuse here? AC is the hypotenuse in triangle ABC. XZ is the hypotenuse in triangle XYZ. So AC is correspondence to XZ. Okay? XZ, this is nothing but hypotenuse, which is nothing but hypotenuse, right? Next, next side is I am taking here BC. You can take any side. Either if you take BC, you can consider here YZ. If you take AB here, you can take XY. Any one side, right? So BC is equal. BC is correspondence to YZ. This is the side. Right angle, hypotenuse, and side. Okay, are equal. Then triangle ABC is congruent to triangle XYZ, right children? So in any right angle triangle, if you observe right angle, hypotenuse and any one side are respectively equal in another triangle, then we can say these two triangles are congruent to each other. Okay, this is the fourth one. So we discussed the four congruence criterions, that is, first one is side, that is triples. Second one is SAS congruence rule. And third one is ASA. And fourth one is RHS. Okay? Triples is nothing but side. Okay? And SAS means side, angle, side. Here angle is included between two sides. And third one is angle, side, angle. Here the side is between two angles. And the fourth one is, the last one is right angle, hypotenuse and side, that is RHS congruence criterion. Please copy this. Right children, let us discuss exercise 7.2. Right? So in the first question is, which congruency criterion do you use in the following cases? So in that first one, I am going to explain A bit. Here they given two triangles, that is ABC and DEF. Okay, in these two triangles they given some conditions. By using that conditions, we are going to apply which congruency criterion to say that these two triangles are congruent to each other. So till now we discussed four congruence criterion, that is, first one is SSS, second one is SAS, third one is ASA and RHS. So these are the four congruence criterions we discussed just now. Right children? So by using those four, we can say that which congruency rule we are going to apply to say that these two triangles are congruent to each other. So they given some conditions. That is, AC is equal to DF, first one. And the second one is AB equal to DE. And the third one is the given, BC is equal to EF. So here, by which congruency property we are going to apply to say that these two triangles are congruent to each other? Obviously, they given these three sides are equal. That is, AC, DF, as well as AB, DE, BC and EF. So, by SSS congruency rule, congruence criterion, or you can write rule also, congruence criterion. So therefore triangle ABC is congruent to triangle you can take, or you can take ACB. Okay, RCA. They written here, they given ABC is congruent to DEF. Okay, first we can consider as AC. AC is equal to DF, corresponding side. AB equal to DE. BC is equal to EF. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF by under SSS congruence criterion. Is it clear, children? Right, in the same way, we can apply for B1. B1, they given two sides and one angle, one included angle. ZX is equal to RP, and as well as RQ is equal to RQ equal to ZY, and they given angle PRQ equal to angle XZY. Okay, so here angle R, angle Z are both are included angle only. So therefore, by using SAS congruence rule, we can say that BBD is congruence to each other. So like that, you can complete C and D. Okay, let us discuss question number 2. Right, please copy this. Right, children, let us discuss question number 2. What is the question number 2 here? You want to show that triangle ART is congruent to triangle PEN. Right, ART is congruent to triangle PEN. Right, so they are given two triangles here, ART, ART, and as well as PEN. So two triangles they are given, we need to show that these two are congruent to each other. So to say that, first one they given, if you have to use SSS criterion, then you need to show that. See, this year we are going to use SSS criterion. Okay, if you want to use this SSS criterion, which corresponding sides are equal to which corresponding sides, which sides are equal to the which side, that we are going to apply. So here first one is they given AR. AR is equal to, this is the first side they took, AR is nothing but PE. Okay, AR is equal to PE. As well as second one is here they given RT. Okay, second one is RT. RT is equal to EM. And the third one is they given here AT. AT is equal to PM. So like this you need to write the corresponding sides. Then we can use SSS criterion to say that triangle ART is congruent to triangle PEN. Right, children? So this is a process to write whatever the criterion you can use. You should write the corresponding parts of the other triangle. You will get these two triangles are congruent to each other. So like that, BBD they are given for SAS congruency rule. And here they are given only two sides. And you should, they given angle T is equal to angle N. In the B bit, they given angle T is equal to angle N. You can take the corresponding sides. That is AT, PN, and RT, EN. Okay? So that you should complete. And even here, for C bit, they given AT is equal to PN. So you can take two angles. Angle A, angle P, angle T, and as well as angle N. For corresponding parts. Right, children? Now let us discuss question number 3. What is the question number 3 here? You have to show that triangle AMP is congruent to triangle AMQ. Right? So till now we discussed two different triangles. Two separate triangles. Now in this question number 3, they given triangles are attached. Okay? Both the triangles are combined. So question number 3, we need to show that triangle AMP is congruent to triangle AMQ. So the given triangles are like this. One is the common side. Okay. Like this they given. Right. So now this is AMP, AMQ. Here these two angles are equal. They given PM, MQ, and as well as they given only these two. So they given the some steps here. Okay. Now steps are one. First one is PM is equal to QM. Why? What is the reason? Reason is nothing but they given. Okay. Reason is given. Second one is second one condition is angle PMA is equal to angle QMA. Okay, PMA is equal to QMA. These two angles are equal. This also they given the condition, right? Here the third condition is AM is equal to AM only. Why? What is the what did you observe from these two triangles? Now see this here. AM is a common side for AMP triangle as well as AMQ triangle. For these two triangles, AM is the common side. Okay, that you should write the reason. That is common side, right? So therefore, fourth one is so this is the common side. So which congruence rule we are going to apply to say that triangle AMP is congruent to triangle AMQ? But these two triangles are congruent each other by using side angle side. That is by SCA's congruence rule. We can say that these two triangles are congruent to each other. Okay, they given the conditions. We wrote the reasons. Right, children, copy this. Right, children, till now we discussed the four different types of congruency of criterions we discussed. So first one is what? Yes. That is, in two triangles ABC as well as PQR, okay, in these two triangles we are going to consider the corresponding parts are equal, the corresponding sides are equal. That is, AB is equal to PQ as well as BC is equal to QR and AC is equal to PR. Then by Triplet's congruency rule we can say that these two triangles are congruent to each other. Only sides, only corresponding sides are equal. The second one is SCA's congruency. That is, triangle PQR and the last triangle DEF. In these two triangles, any two sides and as well as included angle. I am taking PQ, DE, QR, EF, and included angle is Q and E. So then we can say these two triangles are congruent to each other. That is, PQ is equal to DE and as well as angle Q is equal to angle E and QR is equal to EF. So by using this, we can say that by SCA's congruency rule, we can say these two triangles are congruent to each other. The third one is angle side angle. Let us take two triangles, that is ABC and as well as XYZ. In these two triangles, two angles and included side. I am taking angle A and angle B. Here angle X, angle Y. Okay. And let us take the side included between them is AB is equal to XY. Here angle A is equal to angle X. Right? And AB is equal to XY. Then angle B is equal to angle Y. Then we can say that by using ASA congruency rule, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle XYZ. The fourth one is nothing but RHS congruency rule. That is, in any two right angle triangles, let us take here compulsory you can take right angle triangles only. Okay, for the fourth one you can take right angle triangles only. This is let us take that different triangle. Okay, let us take DEF and as well as here one more triangle, that is KLM. Okay, in these two triangles angle E is equal to angle L, that is 90 degrees, and DF is the hypotenuse. Okay, DF is equal to KM is nothing but hypotenuse. Here this is also hypotenuse, and I am going to consider DE and KL. Okay, DE is equal to KL. Then by RHS congruence rule we can say that triangle DEF is congruent to triangle KLM. Right, children, these are the four main criterions of congruency rule, congruency of criterion we can use in triangles. Right, children, and today's homework is you please note down this homework. So I think in homework in question number 1 I explained A bit. You can solve B, C, D. And in question number 2 you can complete B and C. Okay, write the homework. Exercise 7.2. Right? In 7.2, question number 1. In question number 1, B, C, D. In question number 2, B and C. Right, children? I hope you understood that these congruency of criterions of 4 different, that is SSS, SAS, and ASA, RHS. Thank you, children. Have a great day.